就是要比我们平时那个在日常生活中接受为现实的这个东西要
imagine something horrible, but I'm sorry for this. That's the point of it.
他要讲一个比较那个可怕的什么事情，所以他先道歉。
Imagine that one of you beautiful girls were to be, I don't know, terribly raped, humiliated, and so on.
假设我们有一个那个美丽的女孩子，就是有人被强奸了。
Isn't it that if things get too terrible, you simply experience what is called the loss of reality?You no longer feel as real. You no longer feel, my God, this is really happening to me.
当这个事情真的变得过分可怕的时候，你就会失去这个真实感，你就会觉得这可能不是真实的事情，并没有真正在发生。
And this is why I claim modern science is so traumatic.
这就是我为什么说现代科学是非常创伤性的。
For example, quantum physics.
比如说这个量子物理学、
It is real.
它是真的。
I'm not a postmodernist who says everything are just stories.
它不是后现代主义者，就不会说什么东西都是一个故事，都是 fiction.
There is no real science. All that we are telling ourselves are just stories.
它不会说没有真实的科学，我们只是在讲故事。
My good friend.Frederick Jensen sometimes talks like this.
有他的好朋友那个詹明信有的时候是这样说。
Which is why I think we should give him a kind of a how did you call this in Maoist cultural revolution times when you were called and people shouted at you and criticized you. Jensen deserves a little bit of this.
他说这个詹明信有一点需要被那个大家稍微小小的批斗一下，因为他的那个想法。
But on the other hand.If you seriously take the so-called ontological consequences of quantum physics,
如果我们把那个量子物理学的本体论的那个后果，把它认真的思考一下的话，
it is simply totally incompatible with our everyday experience of reality.
它和我们每天日常生活的经验是完全不符合的。
You know, things happen there, like time running back.Strange interaction at a distance, which are in total discordance with what we experience as reality.
比如说，这个量子物理学里面提到的这个时间的扭曲，在这个远距离等等这些问题，跟我们日常生活的体验是完全不同。
And this is why scientists from Niels Bohr to Richard Feynman are right when they say.It is impossible to understand quantum physics.
这就是为什么有的科学家说量子物理学是不可理解的，这是有道理的一种说法。
To understand in the sense of to translate it in the terms of our everyday notion of reality.
是不可能把它用我们的日常生活的用语来描述这个量子物理学。
So, as you can see here, the problem of belief of illusion is a crucial problem in the sense of okay it's a crucial problem.
信仰和幻象的这个问题是一个非常关键的问题。
In the sense that we cannot just take the illusion away and then we will get reality.
并不是说我们把这个幻象抽走了以后，抽取了以后就马上会得到现实。
If you take illusion away, you lose also what we experience as reality.
如果我们把幻象抽走以后，同时我们也失去了真实。
And this, I think, is why our era seems to me so critical.
这就是为什么对我看起来，我们现在这个时代是非常关键的。
Not only scientific experiences, but our life experience is more and more penetrated by things, theories, processes which distort our sense of reality.
不仅是说这个科学经验，也是我们的生活经验中，我们的生活就充满了这些破坏我们对真实的感觉的东西。
And we still try to react it like the guy who was.Attached to his hamster.
但是我们行动的方式还是像那个他的那个朋友，就是对豚鼠有执着的那种方式，逃避的方式。
Unfortunately, religion different religions offer themselves as hamsters.
经常的这个宗教就把他们自己表现成这样的豚鼠，这样的。
Not just Tibetan Buddhism, but for example, also in Europe,
欧洲的那个
Catholic Church often
天主教会
often acts like this. Their message is.If we open ourselves to modern science and so on, life will become meaningless.
他这个天主教会的这个想表达的意思是，如果我们对现代科学，如果我们就是接受现代科学的话，我们的生活就会变得毫无意义。
Like, you will have science, but we will provide you a frame which will keep science within.The limits of normal, meaningful life experience.、
这个天主教会的意思就是说，你们可以有这个科学，但是由我们教会来给你们提供一个框架，把它限制在一个能够让生活仍然有意义的范围之内。
For this, of course, they say we have to limit science a little bit, not go too far.
当然就需要把科学做有所限制，不能让它走得太远。
I think this is a tragic misunderstanding.
我认为这是一个
false role of religion.
非常悲剧性的误解，就是把宗教的角色理解成这样，是非常悲剧性的。
The problem is then how to kill the chicken or the hamster.
这问题就是说，那我们应该怎样把这个机会的这个豚鼠给杀掉呢？
Because did you notice how it's What I want to impress you with is how universal and common this structure of we need a hamster or a chicken who doesn't know is in our daily lives.
就有一点就是很那个让人吃惊，就是说在我们的生活中，我们对。